On the 7th of March 2025, Microsoft unveiled a family of in-house AI models called MAI, or Microsoft Artificial Intelligence. Today, I'll take you on a journey into what this new, ambitious AI system stands for. You'll see how MAI is pivotal to Microsoft's AI strategy due to its revolutionary architecture and unique training methodology. Stay tuned to the end for my honest take on what this means for developers building on Microsoft's cloud, Azure, and whether Microsoft is ending their partnership with OpenAI. Under the leadership of Mustafa Suleiman, Microsoft's AI division has been making significant strides with a new set of AI models known internally as MAI. According to reports from The Information, the team has dedicated considerable effort to developing, training, testing, and refining these models. They aim to evaluate how well MAI can handle various tasks, assessing its versatility and potential applications. Microsoft wants to make these reasoning models excel at generating clear, direct answers while showcasing their thought processes in a structured way. This approach is especially beneficial for tackling complex problems across various fields. For instance, these models can assist with medical diagnosis, ensuring accurate assessments in healthcare. Similarly, they play a crucial role in scientific research, helping to unravel multi-step questions. In manufacturing, automated decision-making benefits from this structured reasoning, leading to more efficient processes. Additionally, these models provide valuable insights that help organizations navigate uncertainty for financial risk assessment. The team has tested MAI in enhancing Microsoft's Copilot AI assistance, as Microsoft aims to improve user experience and productivity across its suite of tools by focusing on this integration. This innovative approach highlights the company's commitment to advancing AI technology in practical, user-friendly ways. The information also reveals that Microsoft is exploring AI models from various companies, such as Meta Platforms, xAI, and DeepSeek, as potential substitutes for OpenAI technology in its Copilot products. This move indicates Microsoft's desire to reduce its dependence on OpenAI, with which it's partnered since 2019. The tech landscape keeps evolving, and it seems Microsoft is trying to diversify its AI resources to stay competitive and innovative in the rapidly changing market. Is this dual focus on internal and external AI models a sign of Microsoft's competitive strategy? Let me know what you think about this in the comments. One of the most groundbreaking advancements for Microsoft is the introduction of the Belief State Transformer, or BST. This innovative AI architecture has the potential to transform the way AI models process data and generate information. You might wonder what exactly differentiates BST from others and how it redefines AI processing. Let's see some of its key features. Bidirectional processing is the main concept from BST that separates MAI from traditional AI models. Typically, older models only look at text in a linear fashion, processing it from left to right. But with BST, there's a significant upgrade. It's like having a conversation where you can draw insights from what's said and about to be said. This dual analysis allows for a much richer understanding of context, leading to more coherent and accurate outputs. I find this approach intriguing because it mirrors how we naturally communicate. When chatting, we don't just focus on the last word spoken, we consider everything around it. That's what BST does. Considering the words before and after a given term enhances the overall clarity and relevance of the content produced. It's a game changer for anyone looking to harness the power of AI in a way that feels more intuitive and human-like. Another exciting advancement in MAI as a result of BST is something called goal-oriented reasoning. This technology enables artificial intelligence to solve complex tasks with a multiple-step approach. Imagine the possibilities. With this capability, MAI can make sense of complicated problems and plan out effective solutions in an almost human-like way. It blows my mind to think about how much more powerful this makes AI for planning and problem-solving. Instead of spitting out answers, it can analyze a situation, break it into manageable chunks, and work through them methodically. This means that whether it's optimizing logistics, strategizing for a project, or even navigating everyday challenges, AI can handle it all with impressive finesse. It's like a supercharged assistant, always ready to help you tackle whatever comes your way. If you're enjoying the video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe, and leave a comment below. I appreciate your support. Now, let's get back to the video. Microsoft AI's family of models also produce more coherent outputs. BST has stepped up the game, enabling these models to generate coherent, well-structured, and logical narratives. These advancements can transform how we interact with technology, making the outputs more relatable and easier to follow. What's more, MAI's performance on initial benchmarks is nothing short of impressive. It appears to be holding its own against heavyweights like OpenAI and Anthropic. This could be a game changer for Microsoft's suite of products, potentially giving them a significant edge in this competitive space. It's always thrilling to witness innovation that pushes the boundaries of what we thought was possible. Meanwhile, Microsoft has ditched the traditional methods of training AI models. They're incorporating something called chain-of-thought techniques into the mix. This advanced reasoning process helps the AI generate answers by breaking things down into intermediate steps. It's like taking a journey through thought, where each step builds on the last, leading to a more comprehensive and nuanced answer. It's kind of like how we humans think out loud, processing our thoughts in a way that makes sense before a conclusion. Using this approach alongside BST is a game changer. Why, you ask? A combo of both strategies seems to enhance the model's capabilities. Allowing the AI to reason step by step improves accuracy and helps tackle complex questions more effectively. It's like giving the AI a roadmap, ensuring it doesn't just leap to conclusions, but navigates through its reasoning. This blend of techniques could revolutionize AI development. So, how did Microsoft and OpenAI go from partners to competitors? With an investment of around $13.7 billion in the partnership, Microsoft has long been a key investor in OpenAI. This financial commitment secures them exclusive access to OpenAI's cutting-edge technology through Azure Cloud Services. It also comes amid scrutiny from the UK competition watchdog. They accused Microsoft of trying to poach startups and consolidate power. However, both players seem to have navigated the complexities of collaboration and regulation unscathed, as the Competition and Markets Authority, or CMA, later dropped the probe into their partnership. But here's where it gets interesting. We've seen signs of rising tension between Microsoft and OpenAI. I sense it's due to Musk's lawsuit against OpenAI for trying to ditch their agreed-upon nonprofit structure as an early investor. Musk recently approached a federal judge in California with a bold request. He's demanding an order to stop OpenAI from leaping from a nonprofit to a for-profit organization. His argument hinges on a report released by the FTC on January 17, 2025, that points out that Microsoft is positioning itself for dominance in cloud computing, especially as the artificial intelligence market is booming. It's quite a situation, right? Musk seems to believe that this shift at OpenAI could further tip the scales in favor of Microsoft, and he's keen to halt any moves that might make that happen. As a result, Microsoft has decided to reduce its dependence on OpenAI and started developing and refining its AI innovations. By doing so, they're trying to get Musk off their backs and positioning MAI as a formidable competitor in the tech landscape. It's an intriguing development that could reshape the dynamics of AI technology moving forward. Microsoft has solidified its AI ambitions by making significant investments in AI infrastructure. In fact, they plan to pour a whopping $80 billion into AI data centers in 2025. A portion of this funding will go towards establishing centers in India. This strategy highlights Microsoft's dedication to advancing AI and mirrors a broader trend across the industry. Companies everywhere are racing to develop next-generation AI technologies. It's an exciting time for the tech world, and Microsoft's moves are making waves. The team is putting MAI through some serious testing and integration. They're weaving these advanced tools into many of Microsoft's most widely used applications. One of the standout features is the AI-powered Copilot, which assists users in tasks like writing and coding. MAI will also be incorporated into cloud computing services, allowing Azure developers to make the most of it through APIs. Imagine having a virtual assistant that helps you draft emails or reports and provides real-time suggestions to enhance your writing. For coding, Copilot can streamline the development process by suggesting code snippets or debugging tips on the fly, making programming more efficient and less daunting. MAI's capabilities allow Azure developers to interact with APIs, facilitating smoother integration and innovation. It's all about making technology work smarter for users and enhancing productivity and creativity. And there you have it. The AI space is changing faster than ever. With Microsoft's unveiling of MAI, the launch of BST, and significant investments in AI infrastructure, it's clear that the company is gearing up to take the lead. We're on the brink of exciting breakthroughs and innovative applications that could reshape our everyday lives. Plus, we might even see some competitive pricing along the way. What are your thoughts on the MAI models? Do you think they'll revolutionize how we interact with technology? I'd love to hear from you, so drop your opinion in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video and want to stay updated on all things AI, don't forget to like, subscribe to our channel, and hit that notification bell. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.